Welcome back, friends. In this video tutorial, we'll be looking at the photoperiodism and examples of photoperiodism. And let's talk about the basics of photoperiodism, that is, what is photoperiodism? Photoperiodism means plants are responsible for the development of their flower. It depends on the different wavelength of light. So as the light comes into the plant has different molecules inside it, which are called phytochromes, which are sensitive to light, which can respond according to the light wavelength that is hitting on it. Okay, so depending upon that, plant can sense whether it is getting more daylight or it is getting less daylight, whether it is getting more dark period or it is getting less dark period, and that thing is called as photoperiodism. Okay, now we'll be doing a separate video on photoperiodism and what is it differently, but in this video I'm going to talk about certain examples of plants regarding this photoperiodism. Now it actually reflects onto the flowering of the plant, that what kind of photoperiodism it is going through. For example, some plants are there which can develop flower if they get more daylight, and there are some plants which can develop flower if they get less daylight. So the light throughout the day is responsible for the development of flower of the plants. Okay, so here in this case, depending upon that particular criteria for getting the light for longer duration or shorter duration, we divide the different plants in these five different groups, and these are the short abbreviations that I have written. Now this first one is SDP. Now actually it was previously thought that light is responsible for the development and growth of flower in plant, or it is responsible in the flowering of the plant, but nowadays it was found that not only the light, but the duration when they won't receive any light, that particular time is more responsible for the production of flowers. It's kind of opposite, but the theory becomes the same, that is, this first type is short day plant or SDP. Now the short day plant means this type of plant can put flowering pretty fast when they get short duration of daytime of a particular critical range. So how can we compare that this is a short daytime plant, this is a long daytime plant, this is LDP, is a long daytime. So how can we make to know that this one is short daytime plant, this is a long daytime plant, and all these things? How could we know? Now for that thing, we are having a critical day length. A critical day length, right? So let me write it as like this. So critical day length here. Okay. Now if there is a day length increased of this critical day length, we call it long day. And if there is a day length less than critical day length, or critical value of the day length, we call it a short day. Okay. So in this case now, short day plants, they require less day length than the critical day time for developing flower. In case of long day plants, they require long day time or more day time greater than this critical day length to produce flower. Similarly, and this, so the examples are also given. The short day plants, that means they require short day time. Say, if we divide the daytime into 12 hour, they, in this case of short day plants, they require 6 to 8 hours of the day length. Not 6, actually 8 to 9 hours of the day to put the flower on. If it exceeds that particular time, the flowering is not proper in case of the short day plants, right? Because they are accustomed to that particular property. Now the long day plant, they require 12 to 14 hours a day for getting the flower on. Example is beet, wheat, spinach. Short day plant example is Nicotiana tobacum. In case of DNP, or it is called day neutral plant, these are the type of plant, the day length is not leading to any effect onto the plant, like this day neutral plants, like cotton, tomato and maize. These are the plants, the day length is not at all responsible. Okay, so it actually depends on whatever day length it is 10 hour a day, 8 hour a day, 14 hour a day, there leads to no effect onto the flowering of the plant. It is not responsible. In case of SLDP, it is called short long day plant. That means in this kind of plant, example is Trifolium repens. Now this kind of plants, like short long day plant, in this case at the very beginning of the budding process, they require short length of the day, or less than the critical day length. but followed by the long time during the blossoming of the flower. So during the budding of the flower, they require short daytime. During the blossoming of the flower, they require long daytime. And this type of plant is very rare because they require certain change in the daytime. And this certain change in the daytime can only be found in certain temperature, certain condition in particular areas in the world. So you find very rare example of SLDP plants. Then we are having LSDP or long short day plant. This type of plants are again rare because for this plant to flower, it requires a long day period followed by a short day period. So that is the timing. So long day, then a short day. So this type of transition can only be achieved at a particular time duration in the year. So for that reason, we can see flowering of this type of plants very rarely in some particular time in the whole year. So these are the different way of photoperiodism. But remember one thing, that nowadays it was suggested that the photoperiodism is more depend upon the climate or the night time or the time that won't get any light, because for all this process to conduct, there requires a molecule that present inside the plant, and that is called phytochrome. Now this phytochrome is a very important molecule which is responsible for doing all this. These are called FR, and another form of the phytochrome is called PFR, which is the active form. Now phytochrome can be converted to PFR when it receives some light, red light actually. So depends upon this whole process, that's why they change in flowering during the duration change in the daytime. So that is the basis of photoperiodism, and I hope that's helpful. Thank you.